Hi, this is Scott Devine at scottsbasslessons.com. Today we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to practice arpeggios. When you probably started playing an instrument, you were told that it's really important to practice scales and arpeggios, and it is, because scales and arpeggios are the alphabet of music, but there's a whole load of different ways to actually practice them to make them more usable within your playing. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. For today's example, I'm just going to take a 2-5-1, which will be D minor, G7, C major 7. So that's a 2-5-1 chord progression in the key of C major. D minor 7, G7 dominant, and C major 7. If you check out my website, there's a downloadable PDF that'll have that information on it and all the other relevant information for this lesson, so just hop over there and download it for yourself. So, arpeggios. First of all, you need to learn each arpeggio from three positions on the neck, or should I say, three different fingers of this hand, of your left hand, or right hand if you're a left-handed player. So let's start with the D minor. Now in this first position, the first five frets, let's start with the D on the little finger. Next we've got the F on the D string with the second finger. Next with the first finger is the A on the G string. And then the next one with the little finger is the C on the G string. This gives us, and if you've got a high C on your bass like I have, you can play the D there. If you're playing a four string, just for now, don't do this. Don't do that for now. It's fine to do it while you're improvising and stuff like that, but just for now, stay there if you haven't got that D within that position. And I've also got an F there, so I can go D, F, A, C, D, F, and down. Now I've also, so that's, say, for instance now, that's D minor arpeggio from my little finger. But you'll also see that we've got a D, F, A, C. We've got the C here. We've also got a C here as well. So on the way back down, C, we've actually got another A here on the E string, and then we've got an F here. Now, this from the D to the D, yeah, that's your D minor arpeggio. But the full D minor arpeggio within this area actually starts on the F. That's all your arpeggio notes for D minor within that one area. Here we go again. So when you learn an arpeggio, for instance in this position, make sure you don't just do that, you know, or that. You know, there's so many more notes there within that position. Now the next position for D minor is with your second finger. So your second finger on the D of the E, of the A string, with your first finger you're playing F on the D string, with your little finger play on the D string an A note, so you've got D, F, A, C on the G string, and then D on the G string. And then if you've got a C string like I have, you can play the F as well, so you've got, or if it's a four string. Now remember, we've also got this C here. Also got this A here. So now in that position we've got D, F, A, D, if you've got a C string, F, and back down, D, C, A, F, D, C, A. Okay? So let's look at them two positions. The first one, starting on the little finger. The next one, starting on the second finger. So we could just to show you what I mean about going between the two of them, you could go. There I was kind of going in and out of both of them. Now the next one of the D minor starts with your first finger on the D of the A string, little finger on the F of the A string, third finger on the A of the D string, first finger on the C of the G string, third finger on the D of the G string, and then if you've got a C string like me, first finger on the F of the C string, and then little finger on the A of the C string. So that's just ascending. And then going down, we've got a C here and an A here. The C and the A are also within the D minor arpeggio. So there we've got three positions. We've started with our little finger, our second finger, and our first finger. The little finger position here. Second finger position. First finger position. Now, if you go here, we start with a little finger again. Okay, so it starts repeating itself again, but on different strings. We've got D on the little finger, same shape. And when we get to this D here, this shape actually borrows from this position here. See? So we've got. Then you've got the second finger, as before. This one was down here. Now it's here. Now when you get to the little finger, that this position here starts repeating itself. So you've got, and then I'll leave it up to you to, you know, go through all the other arpeggios and find out the different shapes. So just as a brief look through the D minor arpeggio, here we go. Fourth finger position, second finger position, first finger, fourth, second, first, yeah. So you get what I'm saying. So that's just with the D minor. Now, you do the same with the G dominant 7. So the first one down here will be starting your second finger. G, B, D, F, G, B, D, F. The next one would start your first finger. G, B, D, F, G, B, D, F, G. Yeah, so that's your the second you started on, then the first. Let me think. So we've got a first down here. We've got a fourth up here. So this is one of your fourth. G, yeah, B, D, F, G. So the gag is to link them all up. So you've got this one. Repeats itself there. There's your. Can't talk while I'm doing it. So break it down into manageable chunks. Learn it in manageable chunks, yeah? So first position, second position, third position, could be, then fourth finger position. Anyway, I'm going to stop it there. This is part one. Check out part two for the rest of it. Cheers, bye.